You're just like my favorite song going round and round my head. Like my favorite song going round and round my head.
He's a Belgian made. He's an international electronic superstar. He's got many, many multi-platinum singles. He's now truly an internationally owned and adored in South Africa electronic producer. His name is Lost Frequencies, and he joins me live from Paris to talk about your brand new record. I mean, where are you now? Lost Frequencies has just gone gold officially in South Africa.
Yeah, I'm actually super happy because we get like an amazing start. And when the start was great, and we were like, whoa, this is super nice. And then you know that usually it goes like you have a really quick start, and then it goes down a little bit, and then it starts to grow. And then usually the next 2 weeks, you see when it's growing, you kind of hope it's growing somewhere, you know, you never know. And then where now it just kept on growing since then. So every week we're more happy and more happy. So I'm not going to complain.
And I just laughed a little bit when I saw that you and Calum Scott started talking, because he approached you to do an official remix of Dancing On My Own, which I think is like one of my favorite renditions of Dancing On My Own ever, 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 including the original, no disrespect. Firstly, how did you make it COVID-wise? Did you guys end up meeting before, or was it from a distance?
But it's funny that you talk about Dancing On My Own, because he actually asked me to remix it.
Yes.
Back then. And I didn't do it because the track was very mellow, very slow, and I was like, I'm gonna destroy this track. I don't wanna do it. I don't wanna release a remix and everybody goes like, ah, what about remix? So I told him, I'm so sorry. If I have to do a remix, I have to speed it up or I have to cut it down, and etc. But we stayed in contact, and when I was making Where Are You Now, I thought about him and I sent it to him, and he was like, yeah, let's do this. He made the vocal, and we didn't really, like, he did it in the UK because it was at the moment it was lockdown. Like, it was hard to travel, and he nailed the vocal like 100%.
You're just like my favorite song going round and round my head. Like my favorite song going round and round my head. You're just like my favorite song going round and round my head. Like my favorite song going round and round my head.
And in the song about Where Are You Now, where did that come from in those lyrics? They're very powerful.
It's really weird because in the very beginning, I was not a big fan of the track. I was like, okay. And then in the end, Calum sang it and was like, this is it. And I was super happy. Like, there was something I liked, but then it's so funny when you should hear like the very first demo that I got on what I started working compared to what it is now. It's like miles away from it, but, and then you have to get the emotion right, and the pronunciations of a few words maybe changes everything. So I'm super happy with how it just turns out to be like it's today.
And I mean, I know that you, when the song came out, were just so excited to perform it live with Calum. And I know that in the last few years, particularly, weirdly, you got screwed by COVID because you had an iconic Tomorrowland set as you were moving towards live elements with your musical performances, and you were excited for doing more of that. And then you explicitly said, this song I want to do one day live with Calum in the same place. Has that happened yet, or are there plans for it to happen?
We did the show. He came to sing, but I was doing the DJ set, and he sang on top. But he nailed it. Like, we did a sound check. I went in front of stage to listen to his voice, to listen if the mix was right, and I was like, it's gonna be so nice tonight. It's gonna be so nice. And then during the show, he came up on stage and he sang, and it was like, I think this is such a highlight right now. It's happening. Like, this is such a good moment. But I hope we can do it again soon with the whole live show, with the, like you said, like with the guitarists, the drummers, the singers, and then Calum comes on stage and he sings a track, and we are playing the track live, and it's a completely different vibe again. That would be really something nice.
Is opening up at different rates in different places. I mean, we've been seeing extraordinary music festivals happening in the United States for a little while now. South Africa's not so lucky, but you've had your fair share of incredible international touring and success. What are the few festivals that you're really looking forward to going back to again?
I'm looking forward for Tomorrowland, of course. That's like my home festival, which is kind of a crazy thing to say, because if you would tell me like 8 years ago you're going to play Main Stage Tomorrowland, I would be like, no, never.
Home set and then, Tomorrowland, imagine.
Homecoming, yeah.
Yeah.
And then a few festivals in the US. Like, if I can, my dream is to play the live show on Coachella.
Wow.
So if we can do that, then I can just die in peace.
It's been like you've been ripped out and made to cold turkey by not being able to go live in front of fans. And now you're getting it back and you all look like four-year-olds on a sugar rush. Like, you're so happy. What is it like to finally reconnect with fans, you know?
I went to Las Vegas a few weeks ago.
Amazing.
We did Life is Beautiful, which is a really cool crossover festival. Like, on the headliner, there was like Billie Eilish and Tame Impala. So, you know, like, there's not only DJs, which is my favorite kind of festival, because the crowd usually also is more open-minded and more reactive to different kinds of aspects of the music. And we arrive on stage and we see everybody going nuts and like, you know, you can eat this energy for breakfast. Like, what's going on here? And then I was like, I just can't wait to go on stage. No, I'm mad. You know, like, what's up? I want to go. And then right before the show, I was there. I was behind the DJ booth. I was like, I'm so scared. You know, what if I mess up? You know, it's been so long. And then I go on stage, and it's just like 1 hour 15. It was so nice. It was
amazing.
So nice.
Listen, Felix, better known as Lost Frequencies, thank you so much for your music. We can't wait to see you in South Africa at some point. You're so, so welcome. And we love playing your records on South African airwaves all the time. Where Are You Now has gone gold in South Africa, and I'm sure it's going to go much higher. Appreciate you, brother.
I can't wait. And hopefully when I come, I can come by to the studio and we have another talk.
My man, I'm going to hold you to that. You better be careful.